This is Anna, also known as Anna Nita on Ravelry. There we have a group which has the same name, Anna Nita. Anna, no blank, Nita, you can easily find it. And on Instagram, my name is Annalena Nita. I'm coming to you from Austria, Lower Austria, near to Vienna, but I am born in Northern Germany, but I'm living here since quite a bit, 2009. This is a knitting podcast. Yes, that's it for introduction. We will start with my works in my work in progress, because I really did only knit on one object, as I told you in the last vlog. Yes, in the last vlog. At the moment, I'm pretty monogamously knitting on only one project at a time, because I like to have quicker process and a finished object of the needles. Yes, and yesterday in the evening I tried to knit at some of my socks, but I didn't get in the flow, so I stay and stick with my one at a time project. And this is the Jujuy shawl by Joji Locatelli I am knitting. I'm knitting this out of Gnome Acres Chai Chai, which is this colorway. It's a pretty new colorway. Yes, Chai Chai. Looks similar to Waffles, but you can't see it in my shawl. But this has another, I think, pooling than Waffles. The waffle colorway has kind of not really speckles, different pops of the lighter and the darker colors, and this one is very regular pooling. I don't know how I could explain it. And my second colorway is a natural undyed yak and silk blend. Yes, it has a very nice drape. Yes, the draping is indescribable. I knit a featherweight cardigan in the past out of this, and I have a featherweight cardigan on the needles in another undyed colorway from out of this blend, and I love it. It's from Austria. And that's my progress so far. Yes. Okay, it's not that easy because it's on the cord here. That's the way why it curls. I want to show you the right, it's the right, in the right direction, you know. Okay, there you see what I mean by pooling with Chai Chai, but I like it. I like it very much. I love those natural tones. Now I will show you the other way around because it's easier with the cord. That's the wrong side, I guess. Yes, but I think both sides are very pretty. And the pattern is asymmetrical. In the lace section, maybe you can see it. It's so difficult to show. It's not easy, I promise. Yes. There you see there's much more. I don't want to click with the needles all the time, you know. There's more lace than here. Because in this pattern you do short rows. You increase on both sides, but the pattern increases in one direction with short rows. Just wrap and turn. Very easy. Yes, and you have to do SSK and knit two together. And the knit two together wasn't that easy to do with my needles because I have higher hires here, but there are no, that's better, but these are no higher sharps. It was just a mistake. I wanted to order higher sharps. They are very pointy in if you compare them to others, but not pointy enough to be a pleasure to knit two together. So I thought, is there really a difference? So I did in the last three rows of pattern, just slip knit, and there is a difference. There, one is left leaning and the other one is right leaning, and so you just for you to know if you come in the same. Oh, the microphone! I don't want to click. Yes, I think you can see. Yes, the three rows under the striping create a line. The holes create a line. Do you see? And under this, it's always left, right, left, right, left, right. And so I think you can see. I don't know if you see it because the knitting is in front of me and I can't watch the screen, but I guess you can see it. So you really have to do slip knit and knit two together, or you don't mind that you have straights. Yes, you know, lines of holes. I don't know, so far I'm pretty content, but we will see. But I love how the colors play together. Oh, I love those tones. I so love them. I said it many times before. Blues and these earthy natural tones are my absolute favorite colors. I love all the bright colors as pink, orange, red, but not for garments and accessories. I use those colors just to have fun in my socks, because who cares about how your socks are looking? Only you know, and you don't have to pay attention if your socks go well with the rest of your garments, you know? And so these colors are my comfort zone. Is the comfort zone something negative? So many people use this word in a negative way. But I think comfort zone means it complements your eyes, your hair, your skin, you know? It's just good. It's so pretty. But to be honest, at the moment I'm a bit bored with the striping, because the lace pattern was on the one hand very easy, but you had something to do. Every row is a bit different. And then the striping gets a bit boring. Maybe because it's garter stitch and not stockinette, so you really do have to do the knit stitch on both sides, and that's not so exciting, but it's okay. It's definitely okay. Oh, this color is so pretty. Chai chai. I guess I have to order more chai chai. And I also want to try waffles. But at the moment, I can't spend money on yarn. It's not possible. Maybe for my birthday, I don't know. In February. It's so soon. I love birthdays. I love cake and presents. Ooh. And I hope my friends know that I want to get yarn. Yes, gift cards for yarn shops. Great thing. Okay. That's my only work in progress. Now I can show you. Yes, I will show you my first try of dyeing yarn. Because it's always very expensive to buy hand-dyed yarns, I thought, try it by yourself. And I did some mini-minis, just to check out on my Stitch and Time blanket. And I will show you my colorways. I'm so bad at winding minis. I'm sorry, they look awkward, but I think the colors are pretty. This one. There we have a purple one. I think it's pretty. This one is cool. Orange, red, and I left some white because I always like, if you can see the bear yarn still. Yes, atonal red. That's definitely not my comfort zone, but for a blanket it's okay. And then my favorite one is this. It's a bit more green than you see it on the screen. So pretty. Very cool. I don't know if I will go on with dyeing. Maybe. But for me, because I don't think that someone is interested in buying hand-dyed yarn from me. Okay, and now I can show you. I showed it in the vlog. It's an acquisition. I received a gift card, a Amazon gift card, an Amazon gift card for Christmas. And I ordered this West Yorkshire spinners. Oh, now I read made in accordance with BS984. Maybe they have a contrasting color also. But I would do contrasting heels, cuffs and toes in white. Do they have a colorway name? Maybe I could search the internet for the real colorway name. I can't even find the number. I don't think that this is the number under the code. Maybe you can read it on the screen now. Okay, West Yorkshire spinners. I love this yarn because it's so. After knitting a pair of socks, you still have plenty of yarn left to knit something else with it. I only knit with the Christmas color with a cherry. I always mess this up with this contrasting color. Cherry, cranberry, I don't know, you will read it on the screen. I can never think of the right name. Yeah, but you all know this Christmas color by West Yorkshire Spinners. And then I did a swap with a lovely viewer. I hope I can say your name. It's Patsy. And she asked me if I want to swap some minis because I said in one of the previous episodes, I think in the Advent episodes, that I would like to swap some minis from my Advent calendar because I like minis, I like swapping, so perfect. And she contacted me and we did swap, or we said to each other, I will give her 100 gram of minis out of my Advent calendar. She could pick. I took a photo and she picked the minis she wanted to have. And she showed me her yarn, but no minis. She showed me whole skeins because I have a lot of minis, as you can see there. And I still have some in addition in another in a bag, and she showed me some of her hand-dyed yarns, and I couldn't decide. I was, oh, I will take this. Oh no, I will take this. Oh no, wait, this, rather this. And so I decide to take, she calls it peaches and cream. It's on the Knit Pick space, but she dyed it. And it is so my color. It looks like, I'm looking over to my cupboard because it looks like the color, just in different tones, looks like my dress for the ball. I will put a photo here of the dress I bought. And these coral colors are totally my comfort zone. I think you can tell. So pretty, but That would have been enough, because I said it's just fair if I give her 100 grams of mini... No. She was thinking I was sending her too much because there are so many minis and only one skein of yarn. And I told her, yes, but it's 100 gram and 100 gram. So it, I don't care that she received some many different minis and I only one skein, because it's the same quantity. And so everything was perfect. And yesterday, no, the day before yesterday, I opened the package and she just was so kind and lovely. And thank you, Patsy. I'm so grateful. She also added this green yarn. And this is Knit Pick Stroll Fingering Cucumber Tonal. Because this colorway was the other one I was tending to. Oh, put this. No, the peach one. No, the green one. Not the peach one. And she wrote on the tag, a gift from Patsy. And it's so pretty. I have never owned Knit Picks. And I heard so much about the stroll. Knit Pick Stroll. It's so soft. What is it? Normal sock yarn. 75% superwash merino and 25% nylon. And the other one, I guess it's the same. No, it's merino wool silk. It is silk. 70% merino and 30% silk. 440 yards. And this has 462 yards. And I guess they go so well together. I think they go very well together. And now... Now I have to show you something. I have another yak silk 50% blend. And I started something, but I liked the way it knits. It was knitting up, but I didn't like the project. And now I guess these three would go so perfect together. It's a hand-dyed yarn. By Volland. You can read it on the screen and you can order from this woman online. She does a great job. It's the... I say it always when I'm talking about her yarns. It's the softest yarn I have ever had in my hands. And these colors are so perfect. I think the colorway name is Autumn, but it looks very springy to me. And with the peach and the green, I think these two complements it very well. So pretty. But there's another option I have. What was it? In a Christmas swap, I received this yellow yarn. It's a bit darker than on the screen. Unfortunately, the lady cut the label, so I don't know if you know the knitting guru, I guess. I don't know. Oh no, goddess, maybe. And it's a normal sock yarn blend. And I have a soft sock by Molly from A Homespun House, heart-shaped box. And I thought maybe these together. No. These would also go well together, or just these two as a shawl. I don't know. Many options. But that's not all from the swap. This wasn't expected. Oh, ooh, earthquake. She also added some progress keeper, and they are so cool. There is this one. So very blessed. Then this one. I think Molly has the same in her shop. Just a skein of yarn. And then the first letter of my name in this vintage material. It's so pretty. And that's still not all. She added some minis, and these are the most and I'm honest, the most pretty minis I have ever received, because the colors are so shiny and the yarn is so special. It's by Yarn Rehab. I have never heard of this before. And the content is 30% silk and 70% merino. And these are, they come together. These are two greens. So pretty and so shiny, you know? Very pretty. And even much prettier. Oh, I can't believe how pretty. A full skein of this would be great. This one. And this one complements it. Do they have colorway names? Yes, this one is called Metal Gold. And this one is called, now I have to, 420. And okay, this one is called Blue Basilisk. I think it's the animal. And this one is called, oh no, I can't pronounce it. No way to pronounce it. You can read it by your own. Okay, that's all in the swap. But all these we only talked about this swapping again, against my minis. And she added so much more. And I'm so grateful, Patsy. Thank you very, very much. And you did such a great job on dyeing this colorway. It's so perfect. I love these colors so much. Like my dress. And I will definitely do something with them together. A shawl. I'm so into shawl knitting lately. I can't think of socks at the moment. Or not only socks, also cardigans. I told you that I want to revisit my featherweight cardigan, but I'm so into shawl knitting. And you see, this gets so much wear. I love this shawl so much. I have so much joy with it. Yes. Okay, these were my acquisitions and swaps and gifts. And that was everything I have on my needles, which I worked on. And yes, now I want to share with you a thing. I don't know if you're interested. You can write it in the comments if you don't want to hear more about it, or if you want to hear more about it. I like series, you know. The last years I only really liked the Gilmore Girls and MASH. But since I have Netflix, I'm able to check out many more series, because the ones I, not that often, but I watched, when I watch TV, I don't have a TV at home, but when I was with something, when I was with someone who was watching TV, I never really liked or enjoyed the series on TV. The two series I'm totally smitten with are, at the moment, are Person of Interest. One viewer told me that she also thinks that Mr. Reese is, so she called him, handsome. Person of Interest. I'm waiting for the releasing date of the fifth and last season. I can so recommend this series. First, it's very interesting, and it's funny. It's a bit criticizing our way we use our modern techniques. Yes, it's about a machine who is controlling and watching us just to help us and to avoid terror. But in the wrong hands, this machine can also spy normal persons and our private life. And yes, I really like this series. And I'm a person who identifies very quick with characters. I have it when I'm reading books, and I'm very sad if I finish a book, and I'm so sad and I miss the people out of the book. And with the series, it's the same. If I really like the series, it depends on the characters. The plot has to be interesting and good, but it goes so much with the characters, you know? And with Person of Interest, you have so many different interesting and very different characters, and they change. No, they develop. They don't really change. They develop themselves. And you can't really foresee it, how they will develop or change, and their opinions and their characters. And yes, it's so... I love this series. Definitely recommended to watch. And because the last season isn't released yet, I had to pause. And I will have to buy it on DVD because I can't wait till Netflix have this online. I think that would take half a year or so. And I definitely can't wait till Netflix will release it. So I have to buy the DVD, and it comes out, I guess, in a few days, a week or so. And the other series I recently started to watch is The Mentalist. Oh my gosh. This series is so cool because I like Patrick Jane so much. He's so different, you know? I don't want to say too much, but he is, as a mentalist does, he is able to read body language very good, and uses hypnosis, I don't know how to pronounce it, I don't want to say manipulate, but to read the people, you know? He's like Sherlock Holmes and so smart, and after a few minutes he knows if the person in front of him is guilty or not, because he is helping the police in California. And yes, but he has a very sad past, because he was using his ability of hypnosis and reading the body language to earn money. So he had his own show, and he was pretending that he was able to talk to deceased persons, and he gave some messages from them. And because he was a cheater, he just made these messages and things up. Because he was a cheater and hurted someone with this a famous murderer killed his wife and his daughter. Yes. And this made much with him and changed him, and he isn't cheating anymore. He is just helping the police with his abilities, but he still want to see this person, the murderer, in prison, because they didn't catch him. Yes. Okay. And yes, this guy is so special, and I always like these smart, talented, and freaky, because of their talent, freaky persons, like Sherlock Holmes, yes, or like mysteries from Person of Interest. It's different, but he's also I can't describe it. Yes, I think it has these persons have a special charm. Often very smart and successful people are, maybe because of their talent, a bit alone in the community. In the society. And because of their outstanding behavior, They are always very interesting for me. They are not normal, they are special, and often also in real life. Often these people have secrets. You can't, most people you can not judge, but you can, most people are like open books to read in, but there are so these few people, and it always, in my opinion and as I experienced it, always these people who are kind of mysterious are smart and very talented and outstanding. I don't know if you understand what I mean, but in the fictional world it's with mysteries and Patrick Jane from Mentalist, and Sherlock Holmes is a very famous example for that, I don't know, appearance. Yes, that's everything for now. I just wanted to tell you what I enjoy to watch during knitting. So this is a shorter episode because I don't have so much to show because of monogamously knitting on my shawl, and maybe I will in the next days put a vlog or so in addition, and we will see. Oh no, we have a knit along going. It's the Anna Knitter blanket along. If you use the hashtag Anna Knitter blanket along, we will be able to see your pretty progress on your project on Instagram. It would be nice if you want to share it on Instagram. And we have a blanket along thread in our Ravelry group. We have some prizes. I showed you 3 skeins of yarn as a prize. Then I will someday in the future receive a project bag by Mama to Abigail. It's a viewer and she has her own podcast, and you can find her on Instagram and on Ravelry with the name Mama to Abigail. She's sewing very pretty project bags, and then you see there the pillow. It's made by Natasha, and her shop or her her shop name is Betsy's Closet, and you can find her on Facebook. And she told me that she will wait till I draw a winner, and she will custom sew with the winner's name a pillow as a prize. So we have 3 very cool prizes, I guess. It's very generous, and I'm open to other donations for our podcast because I can't afford so many prizes, and I don't want to draw only one winner in a year-long knit-along, because it goes through whole 2017. But I want to draw winners every 2 or 3 months. Now that's all, I guess. Yes, that's all. I didn't do anything on my blankets because I'm so smitten with my shawl. I want to have more pretty accessories, and as I told you, 2017 is my garment/big accessory year, because in the last year I knit so many socks, and now I want to go a step forward and knit something bigger and more wearable and seeable. Is this a word? I don't know. So that was everything for this episode. I'm looking forward hearing from you and reading from you. Subscribe my podcast if you want to see more, or give a like so I have an idea if you like this episode and if I should go on like I did in the past, or if I should change something. I'm always open to feedback. If it's negative or positive, I'm interested in both. Come to our Ravelry group. You're very welcome. We want to chat with you and be in contact with you. It's always very nice. I receive once in a while messages, private messages on Instagram or on Ravelry, and I always love to read your messages and your comments and postings in the group. It's what the podcast is about. I started this podcast to be in contact with you guys, and it's wonderful. Yes, I like you all. So we will see each other next week. Bye-bye.